Harry reveals pregnancy is taking its toll on Meghan as they set sail in Sydney Harbour on first day of the Invictus Games, after Duchess skipped morning event to rest. Pregnant Meghan Markle took time out of the royal tour with Prince Harry to rest after their full-on schedule began to exhaust the Duchess, her husband revealed. On day one of their tour, the couple who married in May revealed they are expecting their first child in spring 2019. Days later, after meeting and greeting hundreds of Australians amid a full-on schedule, the Duchess of Sussex took a short break from their royal duties and skipped a morning Invictus Games bike race to rest after a late night at the opening ceremony. The Duke of Sussex flew solo on Sunday morning as he watched the road race through the Royal Botanic Gardens in Sydney and presented medals to the winning riders. As Mail Online revealed, Meghan's schedule was being cut to help her pregnancy, including her skipping the race. Harry told some Invictus competitors his wife was resting back at home, being pregnant takes its toll. But hours later, Meghan was out on the water with her husband to support the men and women taking part in the Invictus Games. The couple and their entourage took a rib out to a yacht, a 40-foot Hans 400 model, where they met an American couple who were cheering on their son. Despite the slightly choppy water, the couple stood up to see the race in action, laughing and smiling as they held onto railings for support. Carrie and Bill Novak, from Illinois, had no idea that the Duke and Duchess would be joining them on their boat. Their son, 26-year-old Ryan, was a first lieutenant in the U.S. Air Force, before suffering a spinal cord injury in 2016. Mrs. Novak said, "They were so lovely." Harry asked what Invictus has meant to our family, about our son's journey, and he also asked after his mental health. "It was so easy to talk to them." Harry said it was good that he had been brought into the program early on. "People can plateau or spiral downwards. We were watching the race and Australia was winning," he said. "Sorry about that." Meghan was asking where we were from. She had gone to university in Chicago near us, and said that she loved Chicago. Mr. Novak told the couple that his son had to wear a TLSO-like a big turtle shell- as part of his treatment and had written the Invictus poem on the back of it. "We showed Harry pictures. We didn't know he would be a part of it back then," he added. The boat was owned by Cam Wayland and his partner Eileen Patterson. Mr. Wayland is part of an organization called RANSA, the Royal Australian Naval Sailing Association, and had volunteered his boat for Invictus family and friends. He was only informed on Monday that they had two VIP guests and was told not to tell anyone. But people did start noticing when teams came and swept the boat with a bomb dog. "They even sent divers underneath it," he said. On board, he said the couple weren't really talking to us, and were focused on the Novak family. However, Harry was struck by the vessel, saying, "The boat is beautiful." The Duke and Duchess then disembarked the yacht and got back in their rib. The team event was raced in Elliott keel boats with a mixed-gender four-person crew in the open category. Each boat was allocated a World Sailing accredited instructor to act as a fifth member of crew and provide guidance on safety if required. It is the first year that sailing has taken place at the Invictus Games. Australia came first, Denmark second, Canada fourth, and USA fifth. Before the event, Prince Harry arrived at the Domain Park nearby and waited about 10 minutes for Meghan to arrive in a three-car convoy from Admiralty House, where the couple have been staying. The Duchess waved to a cheering crowd of hundreds who rushed towards her car as she arrived and pressed against barriers as they tried to get her attention. Prince Harry met her at the driveway to the Pavilion restaurant where the couple was due to have lunch with Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison. Also at the reception was leaders from support and mental health groups for veterans, and members of the Australian Air Force Cadets and Australian Kookaburra Kids Foundation. The Duke walked over and immediately gave her a kiss before taking her hand and walking into the restaurant together, using their free hands to wave at the crowd but not stopping to chat. At the reception, where they met Invictus competitors and other guests including Mr. Morrison's daughters Lily and Abby in a crowded restaurant, the Duchess appeared lively and engaged. Harry was dressed casually in a grey jacket and blue shirt, while Meghan sported a black turtleneck jumper by Australian company Wolford under a $935 blazer by Californian brand Legends. She teamed these with Outland Harriet jeans and her Aquazura Denuve bow pumps, which retail for $1,053. The Australian-designed $199 jeans sold out within hours of the Duchess first wearing them on Wednesday in Dubbo. Meghan finished off her dressed-down Sunday look with a tried-and-tested accessory and another nod to Australian fashion, her $295 Oriton crossbody bag. Harry rubbed her back frequently as the couple greeted numerous guests, some of whom the Duke already knew and was delighted to catch up with. One of them was powerlifter and Tyra Gawthorne, who pulled up his shirt to show Harry a tattoo on his back after he asked if the former soldier got any new ink since the Toronto Invictus Games last year. "I told him it is a traditional Samoan tattoo," he said. Before the event, Prince Harry arrived at the Domain Park nearby and waited about 10 minutes for Meghan to arrive in a three-car convoy from Admiralty House, where the couple have been staying. The Duchess waved to a cheering crowd of hundreds who rushed towards her car as she arrived and pressed against barriers as they tried to get her attention. Prince Harry met her at the driveway to the Pavilion restaurant where the couple was due to have lunch with Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison. Also at the reception was leaders from support and mental health groups for veterans, and members of the Australian Air Force Cadets and Australian Kookaburra Kids Foundation. The Duke walked over and immediately gave her a kiss before taking her hand and walking into the restaurant together, using their free hands to wave at the crowd but not stopping to chat. At the reception, where they met Invictus competitors and other guests including Mr. Morrison's daughters Lily and Abby in a crowded restaurant, the Duchess appeared lively and engaged. Harry was dressed casually in a grey jacket and blue shirt, while Meghan sported a black turtleneck jumper by Australian company Wolford under a $935 blazer by Californian brand Legends. She teamed these with Outland Harriet jeans and her Aquazura Denuve bow pumps, which retail for $1,053. The Australian-designed $199 jeans sold out within hours of the Duchess first wearing them on Wednesday in Dubbo. Meghan finished off her dressed-down Sunday look with a tried-and-tested accessory and another nod to Australian fashion, her $295 Oriton crossbody bag. Harry rubbed her back frequently as the couple greeted numerous guests, some of whom the Duke already knew and was delighted to catch up with. One of them was powerlifter and Tyra Gawthorne, who pulled up his shirt to show Harry a tattoo on his back after he asked if the former soldier got any new ink since the Toronto Invictus Games last year. "I told him it is a traditional Samoan tattoo," he said.